Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at the mobile music platform and running our PD patches on our mobile devices. So in order to do this, we'll be using the mobile music platform, or MobiPlat for short. You can grab it from this website. You can simply Google mobile music platform and it will come up. The mobile music platform consists of an app for your mobile device. It's available for iOS and for Android. And it also consists of an editor that can run on your Mac or PC in order to create interfaces. We'll look at mobile music platform in two parts. In this video, we'll look at running PD patches directly on the device. You can read through all of the instructions for setting everything up at this website. So I invite you to do that when you're ready. So let's create a patch, which is going to be put onto our mobile device. I'm going to create a very, very simple patch. We'll start with an oscillator and we'll set the frequency for that oscillator, and then we'll give the oscillator a volume, and we'll also be able to set the volume for that, and then out to a digital to analog converter so we can hear it. So that's all pretty straightforward. Just to demonstrate that works, there we have our oscillator. Change the properties of that from 0 to 1, so I can easily turn it off. So this will appear on our mobile music platform interface when we put it on our device. These will be very hard to control, these number boxes, so we're going to put some sliders in. So this particular, actually what we might do is just, that's going to have a range by default of 0 to 127, so we might use a MIDI to frequency object to convert that into a more usable frequency range. Now I happen to know that these are going to be quite narrow on our, once they get shrunk down onto our mobile device, so I'm going to change the width of this particular slider. I'll give it a name. This one's going to be a frequency, and I'll give it a color just for fun. So I want to create a slider which is going to control our volume as well. So I'm going to duplicate that so I get the same kind of slider. Change its properties so I go from 0 up to 1. Change its label to be amplitude and then connect it there. We can demonstrate that this works. Oops. So we have our frequency and our amplitude. So that's all good. So what we want to do is to get this particular patch onto our mobile device. So I'm going to save this patch. Let me call it Mobile 1 and put it on my drive. So now, in order to move it across to my mobile device, I need to use whatever application is appropriate for it. In this case, I'm going to be converting it to my iPad. So to do that, I'm going to use Apple's iTunes program. My iPad is connected and I've chosen file sharing and the mobile music platform, and these are the existing files that are in mobile music platform. So if I go to the Finder and find my Mobile 1 PD patch, copy it across to my iPad, then it's just necessary to go to the iPad and check that out. All right, so if I go to my iPad, see there's the mobile music platform app. I can open it up. It has a number of pages. The one that we're concerned with to select our file is the select document page. There are two types of files at the moment. We're interested in the PD files. The PD files don't show up unless you click Show All Files. So I'll do all that, and then we can scroll through the list. There's my mobile one PD that we just created. And so we can turn our frequency up. We can turn our amplitude up. And hopefully you can hear that our PD patch is now working on our iPad. The reason that it's quite small is because the area of the patch that I used was quite large. I need probably to shrink that patch down, and then this will scale up in time. We'll look at how to create a more fancy interface in the next video. So let's leave that there. Have a go with putting your PD patches onto your mobile device with Mobile Music Platform.